The screaming tank engine and his screaming friends. Thomas! The screaming tank engine and his screaming friends. The little engine that couldn't stop screaming. Here's your friend Thomas, the screaming engine. He didn't want to come out of his shed, but he screamed so much that the structures cracked and fell down, killing a tramp that was sleeping inside. So now they are forcing him to work, promising to destroy him afterwards. I hope you like them because nobody else seems to. Your loving father. Land of Cyrodiil is a lush tropical forest. It has bright blue rivers, endless trees, and stable political infrastructure. The land is ruled by Sir Jaxoff. The Fat Emperor. He runs the railway, where all his trains work hard and try to be really useful. However, mostly they just scream a lot and hope that the gods will pity them and strike them down with divine mercy. Oh, sometimes they also pray to Daedra, like Molag Bal, but he just laughs at them. Thomas is the least hated of all the Fat Emperor's engines, because he screams the least. Mostly he cries. He's painted with traditional Golovian colors as well as the blood of the unfortunate woodland creatures who wander onto the tracks. Thomas envies them. One day, the Fat Emperor had a special job for Thomas. He made sure that his knights tied a gag around Thomas first, though, so that he could hear himself think. Now, Thomas, there is a ship from Morrowind coming into the port of Anvil. It is carrying a large load of net jelly for the alchemists. You are to go to the Anvil docks and collect the net jelly and bring it to the alchemists in the Arcane University. If you do this, we might destroy you someday. Maybe, probably not. Thomas's heart would have filled with joy upon hearing this, but his heart had long ago been used in an alchemy experiment, and the years of torture had robbed him of any ability to feel positive emotions. Ah, said Thomas. Thank you, Thomas. You will be a very useful screaming engine, said the Fat Emperor, who was perfectly aware that Thomas had no real will of his own and would be operated by his fireman and mystic overseer, both of whom had silencing spells applied to the cab. When Thomas got to the docks, he saw his friend Percy. Percy was not actually his friend, because Thomas could no longer feel friendship, but the horrible enslavement that they had mutually suffered led Thomas to consider Percy at the very least an ally. Please, Percy, every second I exist, it feels as if I'm being filled with molten coal, said Thomas, who was unaware that he was actually filled with hot coal, being an engine. Percy, I beg you, derail me and rip me to shreds. Let me die, for the love of the eight, let me fucking die. Thomas sobbed as some of the frost salts inside him began to leak out of his body like a baby being crushed beneath an eyelid boot for entertainment. Thomas, I have no arms, nor will of my own, and if I did, I would use it to take my own life, screamed back Percy, who had trouble screaming because his throat had started to bleed. Thomas was not shocked at this revelation of betrayal, having expected nothing but agony in his life, but unfortunately it distracted him and he left without collecting the net jelly. How this was possible when we established he's not in control of himself is unknown, but shut up. When Thomas got to the Arcane University, he was screaming. He always screamed, but this time he was screaming more. He had realized he had forgotten the nuts jelly. Now his small chance of ever finding peace and a quick death would be lost. Ah, screamed Thomas when he really meant, oh dear, the fat emperor shall be so cross with me. What he really, really meant was, ah! Just then the fat emperor appeared, spirited there on the wings of a golden, by the grace of Saint Alessia herself. Thomas, you did not deliver the nuts jelly to the alchemists at the Arcane University, he said. You were so distracted by your selfish desire to end the horrible pain you were constantly in that you were not paying attention, and you have caused confusion and delay. Thomas did not hear any of this because he was, of course, screaming. Just then, in the swirling hell of fiery pain and oblivion that was Thomas's mind, he had an idea. My liege, please, in life I was commanding... My liege, please, in life I was Commander Aventus of the City Guard. I have served you faithfully in the past. I beg you, sir, my agony is too great to bear, but out of love for my emperor and empire, if I retrieve the nuts jelly in a quick time, will you let me die? Eh, I guess, said the fat emperor, who really had no plans to. But this was enough for Thomas, who raced back to the docks, running over several unwary travelers who had not been informed of the railway's nature or establishment. There, Percy had screamed so hard his boiler had exploded. Hot coal getting everywhere like bits of viscera. Unfortunately, this was not enough to kill Percy. It had just stopped him screaming. The crowd cheered when this happened, but Thomas thought Percy had succeeded in taking his life. Thomas believed that if he worked hard enough, he too would be mutilated. For once in the awful bit of time that was his life, Thomas permitted himself to feel hopeful. That will be me, Thomas thought to himself as he raced back to the Arcane University. When he got there, the Fat Emperor and the Alchemists were waiting. The Fat Emperor beamed. Thank you, Thomas, he said. You are a really useful engine that screams. Thomas screamed in response, not happily, of course, because he could never be happy again. Thomas was also already screaming before this. In fact, it should be established that unless otherwise stated, Thomas is always screaming. Sir, please, I beg you, I defended you from 5 assassination attempts when I was a man. Please, by the 8, please kill me. The pain, it is worse than you could ever imagine. Kill me! Kill me! Kill me! Thomas screamed to the fat emperor, who had already disappeared to go ejaculate onto a battlefield somewhere, like he did every Monday afternoon. And Thomas learned never to trust anyone ever again, and the last bit of his heart died there, and with it, any belief he had in the goodness of people. Oh, so yeah.